Iofina has started to produce iodine from its plants in North America from the brine taken from onshore oil and gas wells. It has recently issued a convertible bond at a coupon of just 6.5%, suggesting that it's a company worth looking at in greater detail. Dr. Chris Fay is the executive chairman. Dr. Fay, before we start talking about this bond issue, could you just update us on the company's progress?
Well, Iofina has two plants in operation, one in Texas and one in Oklahoma. Some would deem them to have been test plants, but they are now both showing a good surplus on a monthly basis. So we're already, if you wish, into commercial production from those plants. The key issue, of course, is rolling out further plants.
Let's talk about the $15 million that the company has raised. Is that something that will help you then develop more plants? What's the money going to be used for?
It's going to be used for two things. We could theoretically self-finance plants going forward, but that would be on a significantly lower number in the short term than if we raised this finance. So it's for accelerated rollout of additional plants. And as a secondary reason is that now that we produce our own iodine, we don't have to buy iodine from third-party sources, and therefore we don't get the 60 days credit, if you wish, on those purchases. So we have a working capital not issue, but shall we say, a matter to overcome in the short term, and it also assists in that matter.
Are there any other financial requirements that the company needs to address?
Well, in terms of iodine production, and not talking about water from other sources or talking about other possibilities the company may have, which regarded as an encore, the answer, certainly in the coming period, is that no additional finance is needed, because indeed we believe we'll be self-financing from the production.
Okay. Can you just tell me how many plants Iofina intends to build eventually? What's your long-term target?
Well, that's almost how long is a piece of string. I mean, four are planned for before the end of this year, so we'll be up to six. And then each year thereafter, a minimum six to eight. It could even be more than that. So it's an ongoing number. It's a case, in some ways, of getting the requisite sites. We've got to remember that iodine is very much site-specific. Lots of sites don't have any iodine in the brine at all, so you've really got to find the sites as well, of which we have a large number, many double figures.
And can you provide us with an outlook for the iodine market?
Well, iodine is essentially in short supply, and the reason being is it has far more uses than, shall we say, meets the eye. For example, your television has a thin film of iodine across it, etc., and so it goes on. Pharmaceuticals, agriculture, etc. So it's a case of demand. There has been basically a shortfall or just meeting requirements for some time now. So outlook, probably a steady look for the next 12 months at current prices.
That was Dr. Chris Fay, the executive chairman of Iofina.